In this video, you'll learn about urban flows and how they are organized from households to urban areas. We focus on three important resource flows: energy, water, and waste.
First, we investigate these three flows at the level of a household. Then we will zoom out to the scale of the neighborhood. Finally, we look at the complexity of the city as a whole. Our reference is an average Dutch city. But as you will see, the main principles of urban flows are pretty similar in cities all over the globe. However, how these flows are managed is different in every local context.
Let's start with the flow energy. Energy is used for different household activities, including heating in cold seasons and cooling in warm seasons. In the Netherlands, almost all buildings have some kind of heating for cold periods. In our city, the houses are heated with boilers that use gas as a fuel. The gas comes from pipes underneath the street, which are part of a centralized gas network. The energy infrastructure itself is owned by a large net provider. The domestic heat boilers burn gas to create heat. During this process, carbon dioxide and steam are created, which leave the house through a chimney. This is a waste flow of the energy system. Additionally, some heat will leave the building through walls or windows. We call that waste heat, which is also a waste flow. There are more activities that require energy. For example, storing food in the fridge, cooking a meal, taking a shower, doing the laundry, or watching TV, and last but not least, light. In this case, electricity is provided via a centralized network owned by a net provider. There are different ways to change the inflow of energy to a household. One is to reduce the energy consumption of different activities. For example, by using energy-efficient appliances with an approved energy label, for example, fridges or washing machines. Or by changing behavior, for example, by taking shorter showers. In some situations, it may also be possible to create a different inflow of energy. Photovoltaic cells and micro wind turbines can generate electricity locally. A wood pellet oven or geothermal heat pump can be used to heat or even cool a house. All of these solutions replace the inflow of the central energy networks. We call these decentral solutions. If saving measures and local energy sources are combined, a household can strive to be less dependent on the centralized energy system and from individual or collective solutions. It can thereby try to shift from a linear to a more circular system.